Special thanks to Motionary for sponsoring today's video. In this video, I'm going to show you some pretty cool adjustment layer tricks that you can use inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So first, what is an adjustment layer? An adjustment layer inside Premiere Pro is a blank layer that you can add effects to and apply it over your clips in your timeline, and those effects will be added to the clips underneath it. You can use this in a variety of different ways. One of the most popular ways to use adjustment layers inside Premiere Pro is to use it for color grading. So for example here, to create an adjustment layer inside Premiere Pro, I'm going to go to the New Item button in the Project panel. When we click on it, we can click on Adjustment Layer. Just make sure that your sequence settings match in this pop-up window, and then you can click OK. Then you'll notice a new item appear named Adjustment Layer. You can click and drag this over your clips and then trim it. So extend it by clicking and dragging the right edge over all your clips. This is one of the advantages of using adjustment layers, is that it can go over several clips inside your timeline. So for example, if we wanted to add a color grading effect to this adjustment layer, we can switch our workspace to color and maybe add a LUT. For example, maybe we add this one here. This is a pretty cool looking LUT, but you'll notice that it applies it to all of our clips. So we don't have to manually add this LUT to each individual clip. We added it to the adjustment layer, and the adjustment layer applies it to all the clips underneath it. Another way I like to use adjustment layers is for adding effects and presets. And for this, I like to use Motion Array. Motion Array is a marketplace with tons of video assets like video templates, stock footage, photos, music, and sound effects. And what's really nice is that they have over 50 plus professional plugins that you can use for your video projects. You can use this in Premiere Pro, After Effects, Final Cut Pro, or DaVinci Resolve. I'm a Premiere Pro user, so I'll be showing you some of the plugins in that software. And what's really nice is that they even have a tutorial that shows kind of how to use it, how to apply it inside your editor. So let's take a look at how we can use some of the Motion Array plugins to spice up this sequence. First, I'm going to add my adjustment layer. So I'm going to click and drag once again, drag the right side to just cover all my clips, and we can navigate to the effects panel. Underneath video effects, if we scroll down, they have a lot of cool grunge effects. So if we twirl down, we can add some film damage, which is a pretty cool effect. They even have presets, which are really nice. So if we want maybe a soft film look, we can add that. You'll notice we added this preset on this adjustment layer, and it's over all of our clips. So we don't have to worry about, you know, trying to add it to all these clips, like I said earlier. Another effect that they have that I like to use is called flicker. So this adds a nice flicker to our clips. So if we click play, you'll notice that we have a flicker effect. Once again, you have a lot of different options. You even have presets as well. So let's say if we want to do candlelight, this adds a little bit slower of a flicker. And what's really nice with Motion Array plugins is that you can add and mix and stack them together to create some pretty custom looks. They also have color grading effects and color correcting plugins as well in here. So if we go under the color grading tool, we can go to Cine Style, add that to our adjustment layer. You can see I added a letterbox and a cinematic look to our footage here. So just a matter of clicks, we added a bunch of stylized effects to this adjustment layer using Motion Array's plugins. It was really quick and easy. And this really shows the power of adjustment layers and what you can really do with them. Now this is great, but let's say if you want to save those effects that were added to that adjustment layer, how do you do that? Well, you can create what's called smart adjustment layers. Let me show you how that works. So let's say I broke apart the sequence here. You can see we have all these effects added to this adjustment layer, but then I have these clips over here. I want to add the same adjustment layer over these clips as well with those same effects. But let's say if we go back into our project panel and we simply just click and drag out this adjustment layer, you can see it's blank. It doesn't have those effects that we added to this adjustment layer. So instead, what we can do is on this adjustment layer, instead of adding these effects to the effects controls clip-based level of the adjustment layer, we can add it to the source tab over here. So if we click back over on the clip level, we can select these effects by holding down Command, and I'll just select all of these. We can hit Command X to cut them, click on the source tab, and hit Command V to paste them. Now, when we click and drag this adjustment layer over these clips, you'll notice that those effects are added automatically to that adjustment layer because it's on the source level of the adjustment layer, not the clip-based level inside your timeline. And if you do that, I recommend changing the name of the adjustment layer inside your project panel. So for this case, maybe Cine Style Film Damage or something that relates to your own effects that you use. But that way, you know, you have it labeled, you can click and drag this out, and those effects are automatically added to that adjustment layer. Now you can create a project template where you create a bunch of these adjustment layers or smart adjustment layers, and you have a lot of different effects. You can use plugins from Motion Array or, you know, your own presets and effects that you can build out. But if you do want to check out Motion Array, they have a bunch of plugins. I will leave my link down in the video description. And if you do choose to go with them, you can save up to $50 off an annual plan. Now, I do want to mention that they do have a free account as well. You can download free assets from the website and get started today. So be sure to check them out. Use the link down in the video description. Thank you, Motion Array, for sponsoring today's video. Now let's take a look at another way we can use adjustment layers. So another way I like to use adjustment layers is to create transitions. And this is another common way to use them. Let's say if we create another adjustment layer, what we can do is click and drag this out over our timeline, and then right click on the adjustment layer and go to speed duration to change the timing of it. We can change the timing to maybe 12 frames and then click OK. Then what we can do is click and drag this over our cut point. And once again, we can add different effects to this adjustment layer to make a transition between our video clips. So for example, we can navigate to our effects panel, and one type of transition I like to do is kind of like a zoom in shake effect. And we can easily do this by using the transform effect inside the effects panel. So under distort, under video effects, we can click and drag this to our adjustment layer. And if we go to the beginning of our adjustment layer, we can scroll down and keyframe the scale. So I'm going to click on the stopwatch, click on your right arrow 3 times to go forward 3 frames, and then I'm going to scale up to 150. That will make another keyframe here. And then we can toggle the keyframe or the stopwatch next to position. And then we can go out 1 frame at a time by just clicking on the right arrow once, and we can adjust our position to a random spot. Go forward 1 frame once again, continue adjusting our framing. So we can just kind of adjust this here, go out 1 more frame, maybe go down, go 1 more frame, and then I'm going to click this reset button here to kind of go back to normal. And then I'm going to make a keyframe next to scale. So I'm going to click on this button here, and then go to the end of the adjustment layer right around there, and then reset the value for scale by clicking on that reset button there. And when we click and play this back, we have a zoom in and shake effect. Now you'll notice that it's a little stuttery. What we can do is add motion blur to this to make it more smooth. So if we scroll down to the very bottom of the transform effect, we can uncheck the box next to use composition shutter angle. And then we can change up the shutter angle to 360. This will add some artificial motion blur to your shot. Now when we click and play this back, you can see that we added a nice zoom in shake with motion blur. So that's a pretty cool effect. If you want to apply this over several clips, what I recommend doing is going to the cut point, clicking on your adjustment layer, and click M on your keyboard to make a marker. That way, if you want to add this over your other cut points, you can easily copy and paste by holding down Option on your computer and click and drag it over your other cut points. And with that marker selected, it will automatically snap to the cut points of the other clips. So those are some pretty cool ways you can use adjustment layers inside Premiere Pro. If you want to learn more about Premiere Pro, I will leave a tutorial that you might like right up there. But that does it for this video. Feel free to ask any questions in the comments below, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.